I'm back again with 6 more Adobe Illustrator tools that you should be using for your graphic design projects. That's coming right up, brought to you by Satori Graphics. What is up, people? It's Thomas Satori Graphics, home of graphic design content here on YouTube. It's Monday, so let's kick off this week's content, the Adobe Illustrator tools you should know about. Before we do, however, you can check out my Patreon page linked at the very end of this video, where you find out you can pledge as little as $2 a month to help out my channel. I have some very interesting pledge rewards, so be sure to check it out if you love my content and you want to help my channel prosper. We're starting off today with the Adobe Illustrator Magic Wand tool. For those of you familiar with Photoshop, you might recognize this tool for selecting huge areas of Photoshop artwork. In Illustrator, it works slightly differently, however. If we have a design with many different segments in Adobe Illustrator, you may want to select parts of it that have the same color, the same stroke, and so on. If I want to select blocks with the same color, I can hold down Shift and try to guess which ones are the same by clicking them individually. However, if we take the Magic Wand tool here, the shortcut being Y on your keyboard, we can speed up the process and make it more accurate. You will need to open up the Magic Wand window right here. We want to select objects according to the fill color. By default, this window normally opens at 20 tolerance, which is not going to work well in our situation right here. With a tolerance of 20, if I select a block, it will select many different colors similar to it, but not exactly the same. If I then put the tolerance down to 1 and select a block, it's going to select only that specific color. To show you how the Magic Wand tool also works with things like strokes, I'm going to add stroke weight to some objects. And at the very bottom here, I'm going to add a higher stroke weight too. In the Magic Wand window, obviously we want to choose stroke weight, and then again put the tolerance down so it's going to be most accurate. When we use the Magic Wand tool to select objects, now it's going to select objects with that specific stroke weight only. Here we have a vector lion and a heart symbol. If I want to place the heart symbol multiple times over the line vector in Adobe Illustrator, I can duplicate it over and over. However, this will be tedious and it's going to take some time. Instead, we can use the tool known as the Symbol Sprayer tool. So go up to Window and then open up Symbol Window like so. With the heart symbol selected, we can then add a new symbol in the top right corner and give it a relevant name. If you hold down a click here, you will find the Symbol Sprayer tool. Now all you need to do is select the heart symbol in the window, and then click away to add the hearts anywhere you wish on your design. The next Adobe Illustrator tool you should know about is this shape builder tool here. This is great for joining intricate shapes together to make a single shape. So here are some circles I've added. Select them and then locate the Shape Builder tool here. If you trace the cursor over the shape, you should see, by default, there is a plus symbol above it. You then click and draw over the areas you wish to merge together with the Illustrator Shape Builder tool. Once you've done that, you can also remove areas we don't want by holding down the Alt Option key, causing a minus icon to appear. Like before, draw over the areas with the Shape Builder tool, but this time your lines and shapes will disappear. I'm also going to use this to remove the middle sections. And once you're happy, you can flick the shape over from a stroke to a fill. This Adobe Illustrator tool is great for making logos and icons in Adobe Illustrator. For the next tool, I'm going to create a triangle with the polygon tool to use as an example. Most of us will know that you can go up to Object, Transform and Reflect. This is pretty basic. But also we can use the Illustrator Reflect tool, which will give us a lot more control over how the shape is reflected. You will find it here, and the keyboard shortcut is O on your keyboard. You can then move the crosshair icon around and hold down the Option key to punch in the reflection method. You will reflect the shape or object over this crosshair, which gives you a lot more manipulation than simply going up to Object, Transform and Reflect. Next on this tutorial for Adobe Illustrator tools that you should know about, we have the Reshape tool. This one is pretty unheard of by most people. You're going to find it here, but there is no keyboard shortcut for this one. If I draw a line and then select the Reshape tool, you'll notice this square icon below. You can add specialized anchor points along the line, and then you can move and manipulate it around these points. With the Alt Option key, you can then copy the line over like so, and make some pretty cool designs doing this. Also, you can add anchor points to shapes and then edit the shapes with the Direct Selection tool. The last Adobe Illustrator tool you should know about in today's Satori Graphics tutorial is the Knife tool. You'll find it here below the Eraser and the Scissors tool, but there is no shortcut for it. Select an object or a shape with the Selection tool, and then with the Knife tool you can cut into it freehand style. From there, you can either discard sections or edit the appearance like so. I find this comes in handy for digital art projects mainly. So, did you enjoy today's tutorial on 6 Adobe Illustrator tools you should know about? If you found it helpful, then like and share this video to somebody else. Also, subscribe for 4 graphic design tutorials every single week. And remember to check out my Patreon page as well, if you really want to help my channel. I am a one-man show after all, so every little does help. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.